What is going on, snipers? Naeem here. I hope all of you guys are having a wonderful day today. Let's go ahead and dive right into our daily cryptocurrency analytics for today. We're going to be looking at Verge and why I think over 2018 we are going to see price movements heading upwards, as well as cover what the Wrath protocol is going to initiate for Verge over the next couple of days. If you guys were on our live stream last night, we actually did form this descending triangle here with Verge, and then you can see here we've just broken out of that triangle. And now we see these breakout levels around 1,112 Satoshis. I did place a buy order around 950 Satoshis. If you guys are on our Discord, you guys are aware of that. I did post it under the Verge chat. We actually have this open and free resource for each and one of you guys watching our videos. If you guys want to actually check this out, the link is in the description below. We have a web version, we have a mobile version, and a desktop version. So we actually did post this here on Verge. You guys can go to pinned messages on the top and see all of the information I posted. I also posted an article here that I'll talk about in just a second. But if we go to trading 101, you guys can actually teach yourselves all of these charts. You see that this is a descending triangle, and once again we did break out of that pattern, now forming this little breakout and initiate going upwards. We see the price movements now consolidating just a bit. So I can definitely expect prices over the next couple of days to start heading upwards, being the fact that we do also see a little bit of support around $630. So it looks like our triangle, descending triangle here, literally just went right to about where the support was, more so around this area where we saw this previous head and shoulder form, and now it's forming this little pattern going upwards, which is going to mature over time. So I'm definitely going to be watching this. If you guys aren't on a live stream tonight, we will be covering Verge extensively, watching this price, especially because I just made a buy order. So if you guys are a Patreon, you guys know that you guys get those trade alerts. I am posting them on Discord for now, but if you're not a Patreon, we do have trade alerts. The link is in the description below for that. Now let's go ahead and just kind of look at the analytics here as well. If you guys want to just get a little bit of the backstory here on why is Verge in the news, why are people talking about Verge, it's pretty much a privacy coin that is incorporating a lot of different privacy coin features in one. So Monero right now, in my opinion, is one of the most popular privacy coins. People are willing to pay a large premium in transaction fees just to use Monero's privacy. What's interesting about Monero, the most private, or I guess most exhilarating aspect of it, is the fact that you can't really look at its rich list. If you type in Monero rich list, if you guys don't know, a rich list is where you can see which wallets hold any sort of amount of coins. If you open up Monero's rich list, there obviously isn't any, and you can't track any of their transactions. So Monero is fundamentally private. Really, it is. It is based on crypto note protocol, blah, blah, blah. And it pretty much tells you how you can't pull up that rich list. But if you type in Bitcoin rich list, you can definitely look at who has what amount of Bitcoin. So hopefully that's some food for thought for some of you guys that don't know about rich list. But it pretty much has a private ledger. So everything is done on a private blockchain, something that Verge is lacking. However, what Verge has over Monero is the fact that it encrypts all of its transactions through I2P protection with Tor standards. So it actually puts it through Tor's I2P protection. If you guys don't know what Tor is, it's the .onion browser, I guess you can call it. It's where you have almost the most privacy in terms of your IP address being completely masked and shielded, is what it really is. So Verge right now is in the top 20, has entered the $2 billion market cap. What's really cool about Verge is we did see this pump, which actually brought a lot of attention to it. But what I think is cool about Verge is the fact that it's also a good concept and it has something behind it. So market cap 2 billion, volume at 542 million, large volume there, pretty awesome. And then total cryptocurrency market cap is hovering right under 600 billion at 565 billion. So Verge is definitely taking a little bit of a piece of that as it continuously moves up in coin market cap. Now let's look at what is the Wrath protocol. So this is pretty much where a lot of the controversy is starting. A lot of people are wondering, okay, is this really happening? What's going on here? And Wrath is pretty much going to incorporate what Monero is famous for, which is having its private ledger, into the coin of Verge, which is XVG. And once it's incorporated, not only are you going to have that Tor I2P protection, which you can see on this graph, you can see regardless of what happens on the left and the right, you have that protection, which is already enabled in Verge. But now you're going to have the option, this is what the Wrath protocol is going to do, to actually turn on or off your private or public ledger. So if you want the transaction to be put on a public ledger, but you still want to have the Tor integration, you can do that. Or if you don't want to have your transaction on the ledger, you can use a private ledger and also have that Tor, that Tor implementation of hiding your IP, which Monero currently doesn't offer. Monero has its own form of privacy, however, it doesn't incorporate it and encrypt it with Tor and shield your IP, but they are working on their own update of that, which is interesting. However, a lot of other things about Verge really, in my opinion, put it in front of a lot of other coins in terms of transaction speeds and so forth. What's interesting, though, I do want to cover this. A lot of people are asking, okay, is Verge really going to have this Wrath protocol come out? Because they've announced release dates like 3 times and haven't actually met up to them. You guys have to understand, you guys had to give these people a little bit of slack. My friend actually had a successful ICO. It's called the Gibral Network. And you guys understand, these guys are working day and night. I mean, this is not something that's been around for a long time. A lot of things are new. The problems that you face as a developer in blockchain, it's problems that, you know, you can't really go to an expert about. You have to almost figure it out yourself. So you guys have to really cut some slack for a lot of these developers and these teams that are emerging and creating these new technologies, because, you know, in my opinion, they deserve some grace. So what you're seeing here, this is an official Verge account that just tweeted a bunch of updates of their GitHub. So I actually went into their GitHub. If you guys don't know what a GitHub is, this is a repository of all of the pretty much the codes and resources of any specific project. This is really where developers are you know, kind of going in and developing out whatever specific technology you're looking at, whatever specific company. And in this case, we're looking at Verge. You can see here on their repository, they do have the new Wrath fully implementation here. You can pop this up. So it looks like they are preparing to incorporate this, and this was all added 9 hours ago, and they've been adding and subtracting files here back and forth and different things. But it's interesting because this right here, in my opinion, is a good indicator that yes, they are trying to do something about it. And I also went on one of these other Twitter profiles here, and just to do the most extensive research for you guys, but it says here, this is the lead developer of XVG. I was just looking through this chat here, and you know, they were talking back and forth, but he does mention here, the release is coming this year. So today is December 29th, I believe, and if it's coming this year, December 28th, we have a couple days until it should be released. So that's also something that I wanted to express in this video. It looks like they are probably going to release it by the end of this year. They're already implementing everything. They're putting the files in the repository. So the developer, he tweeted this out. Whether or not this is true, we'll eventually see. Obviously, they've said they were going to do it 3 times in a row. And then to kind of conclude this video, guys, so we pretty much went through Verge, talked about how it is going to incorporate this Wrath protocol by the end of this year, and why I think it's going to, you know, increase in price over time in 2018 especially, and I do have a position in it now. However, if you guys want to look into this coin, I would highly encourage you guys to go on our Discord. The link is in the description below. Go to Verge here, and what I actually did special for you guys is I added these resources here to the pinned messages. So there's actually this article here that I actually posted. You guys can actually pop this article up and just go to the Verge chat. And this has everything you need to know about Verge. This goes into its history, its present, and its future, and what they're incorporating and looking to do. So I would highly recommend looking at this if you guys are interested in investing in Verge. Once again, don't invest in anything that you don't understand, and don't take this as financial advice. Just take this as a perspective. Once again, we don't give financial advice on this channel. So thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. We are looking for somebody to do some graphics for the channel. If you guys can help with that, you can private message Alan on Discord. That's my admin. As soon as you're in the Discord, on the right, his name is Alan. We're also looking for some web designers as well. And we have a lot of great stuff to come over the next couple of days. We just got the new blue mic. As you guys can see, this is what I'm using right now. And we're also going to get some new equipment in terms of a webcam, computer, so that the graphics card is upgraded now. We can actually multi-platform stream and a lot of good stuff, guys. And I want to say thank you so much for allowing Sniper Soup to become such a great success in the crypto market and the crypto community that we're actually building from scratch. And it's such an awesome time for this, and I really appreciate all of you guys, especially the Patreons that have made this possible for us to upgrade our equipment. So if you guys aren't Patreons, the link is in the description for that. And thank you so much for watching this video, guys. Once again, I'll see some of you guys on Discord. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. And with that being said, guys, snipers out.